Hey everyone, Eric here. In this video, we're checking out the Levitate from Sonic Cake. The Levitate from Sonic Cake is a legendary combo in one pedal. We have a delay and a reverb. Now, delay and reverb kind of go together like peanut butter and jelly, right? They just work. What Sonic Cake has done is put both of those effects into a single pedal. Now, Sonic Cake is known for making very affordable pedals, and they're one of my favorite affordable pedal brands on the market today. They make great sounding pedals at a very reasonable, very affordable price for anyone. Before we get into the pedal, let's go over the signal chain. I've got this Pure Salem Cardinal, which has humbuckers in it. We're going into the Levitate and then out into the Boss Katana set pretty clean. The Levitate has two sides to it. We have our delay over here on the right side of the pedal, and then we go into the reverb, which is on the left side of the pedal. Each effect can be turned on and off independently, so we can have just the delay or just the reverb, or we can choose to have both of them on at the same time. Now, each effect has its own set of controls as well, and we have a little line, a vertical line right here that kind of separates the delay controls from the reverb controls. Let's go ahead and go over the delay controls. Now, something unique is how Sonic Cake has implemented the wet signal, because we have a dry and wet, which is the level of our dry signal and our wet signal. If we turn the delay on and we have our wet signal down, we're not going to get any wet signal at all. So if we turn our dry signal up, we're just gonna get the same sound as if the pedal was off. So we can start to turn up the wet control, which introduces more of that delay line into our signal. That also means that we can turn it all the way up to match the volume of our dry and wet signal. And it also gives us the opportunity to completely take out our dry signal or make our wet delay signal louder than our dry signal. Moving on, we have the time control, which is delay speed. With time at minimum, we're going to get an imperceptible amount of delay. It almost sounds like you're in a room. But as we turn that time control up, we're going to start to elongate our repeats and make our delay time longer, so we're going to get a more noticeable repeat. You can hear also that when you strum a note and it's repeating, if you turn that time control, it gets all warpy, as it would if you were manually turning the delay control on like a tape machine. All the way at the top of the time control is 2,000 milliseconds, so that is 2 full seconds of delay time. I also want to mention that the delay line, the wet signal, is kind of modulated a little bit, so it gives you kind of a different tone than your dry signal. It's not just straight digital delay, which is like a one-to-one recreation of your dry signal. It's kind of given a little flavor. Feedback controls how many repeats we have in our echo line. So if we turn it all the way down, we're only going to get one repeat. If you increase the feedback, what it does is it sends the output of the delay back into itself, so you get more and more repeats. And then if we turn it all the way up, with the feedback control at maximum, it kind of rides that line of almost self-oscillating, but it never gets to self-oscillation, so you can really build a lot of soundscapes as you play with that delay. Another feature on the delay side is if we press and hold the foot switch, it lets us tap in our tempo. And then to get out of tap tempo mode, you just press and hold the foot switch again till the light's solid. So moving on, we have the reverb side. Now the reverb side is significantly simpler than delay side. We only have two controls and a foot switch. The reverb side gives you the sound of a plate reverb. In contrast to what we had on the delay line, we only have one simple control for our wet signal on the reverb side. So if we turn it down, we're not gonna get any reverb. And then as we turn it up, we're introducing more reverb into our signal. Moving on, we have our decay control, and this lets us change the length of the reverb or kind of like the size of the room. We go from something like this. As we turn that decay control up, we're gonna get a bigger and bigger room until all the way at maximum, we're gonna be out in space. And the last thing I want to tell you about on the reverb side is if you press and hold the foot switch, you can change between trails or no trails. I just turned into the no trails mode, so that means if I hit a chord and the reverb starts ringing out, once I turn the effect off, the reverb will cut off. Just like that. If we press and hold to turn the trails on, The light flashes to let us know that we did that. And now if we strum a chord, the reverb starts to trail off. Once we disengage the effect, the reverb will actually continue to trail off until it's done. And now I've got my Agape Guitar's Eve, which is a Tele-style guitar, plugged into the Levitate so we can take advantage of having both delay and reverb on at the same time. So what I've set up is a fast repeat, but a lot of feedback. And then on the reverb side, I want a pretty long reverb. Now let's turn them both on. Now we've got my Squier Classic by Precision Bass plugged into the Levitate because bass players need to appreciate reverb and delay as well. Hope you enjoyed this look at the Levitate from Sonic Cake. If you did, please consider subscribing to the channel. That would really help out. Also, if you want to see more gear demos like this one, I've got tons here on the channel, so check the backlog. If you want to purchase the Levitate, I do have links in the description below. Those are affiliate links, so what it does is it saves you time. It just takes you right over to the product. It lets them know that I sent you. And then if you purchase anything, I get a small commission off that. Again, it doesn't cost you anything extra. It saves you time and it's a great way to help support the channel. I also have a Patreon page. I will leave a link in the description. I want to send a huge thank you to all my Patreon supporters. I also want to thank you for watching. I hope you're doing well out there. I hope you're staying safe and I hope you're taking care of yourself. I'll see you in the next video.